keep in touch with the world game. For the latest international and local soccer results, dial the SBS hotline on 1-900-922-333. That's 1-900-922-333.
HP technology and HP people help BMW Williams run every race before the driver ever gets in the car.
Coming soon, the highlights of the 2003 Centenary Tour de France on VHS and DVD. Join Mike Tomalaris and Phil Liggett to witness the drama and action of the greatest cycling event in the world. Reserve your copy now online or by phone order. The first 500 orders will receive a limited edition SBS 2003 Tour de France poster. The highlights of the 2003 Centenary Tour de France, coming soon.
Sunday night, live from Paris, is the final stage of the 2003 Le Tour de France. Join Les Murray for all the action at the Champs-Élysées as cycling's finest cross the finish line.
Only one of them left, that's Damien, here goes McGee.
The final stage of Le Tour de France, live to Eastern States this Sunday night from 9:30. Subaru Symmetrical All-Wheel Drive is a proud supporter of SBS.
I think it's one of the most recognisable.
Tonight on Insight, a special look at Telstra. With the government keen to push through a final sale, we ask, is service and coverage up to scratch? Have efforts to improve rural access been successful? Insight visits several country regions to find out. And what impact is any sale of Telstra likely to have? I'll be joined by a panel including Communications Minister Senator Richard Alston. That's Insight, 8:30 tonight. On Insight, a special look at Telstra. With the government keen to push through a final sale, we ask, is service and coverage up to scratch? Have efforts to improve rural access been successful? Insight visits several country regions to find out. And what impact is any sale of Telstra likely to have? I'll be joined by a panel including Communications Minister Senator Richard Alston. That's Insight, 8:30 tonight.
Album. Music to calm the senses and soothe the spirit.
Utopia.
A double CD of chilled out classics.
Utopia.
For your ultimate well-being, find
Utopia
at Dimmock's music retailers, online and phone order.
Orgasmus hat sich mein Leben verändert.
My real lover, please stand up.
If what's on offer isn't really what you hoped for, and your friends are getting confused,
also das nächste Mal nehmen wir wieder die Räder.
Wollte dich lediglich davon in Kenntnis setzen, dass ich soeben meinen ersten Orgasmus hatte.
Mit meinem Fahrrad, warte.
Geht hin und fahret euch.
The elusive search for reaching zenith. All part of the unbearable pains of puberty. Girls on Top, Friday night at 10.
Sunday. Stirring chronicles of the handful of Indian chiefs who managed to scare the wits out of white men.
There are 12 British forts in the Indian Territory. 8 have been captured, others abandoned, and 2 are under siege.
They have lost their fear of us.
Pontiac's vision saw not all white men as evil, just the English.
Provoke my people to war, and you will find who Black Hawk is.
We launched raids, made the war our own, and made it our way.
This was our homeland.
Chiefs, 7:30 Sunday on SBS.
1, 2.
This is a record I've wanted to make for a very long time. It's all in there just bursting to come out.
A personal homage to traditional Irish music.
Lyrics and partitur.
I think sometimes you can just avoid a song because it'll make you cry, you know what I mean? But those are the ones you should sing.
Sinead has never been afraid of controversy.
Critical of war almost, you know, or to be critical of, you know, America. It's only something I've just been able to do right now because I'm not signed to a major label and don't want to.
Sinead talks of her life and musical influences. A Song of Heart's Desire, Monday night at 7:30.
The spectacle of the film in Gladiator works because it's organically involved with Russell's character. It isn't just something that's thrown out there for a yahoo.
He becomes this champion, this famous gladiator. And he's, of course, put against all odds by being on foot in the arena with 12, 16 others. But he's fighting charioteers who are armed with crossbows and bows, and the chariots have got blades, and so the odds are pretty stacked against him. And of course he utilizes his intuition as a general to rally his forces, form his own castle in the middle of the arena, and let these moving chariots come to him.
Discover the world of the epic movies, Wednesday at 7:30.
Monday,
21st.
PM. Friday, Tuesday,
25th.
SBS should get their act together.
I'm very disappointed.
We all appreciate you very much.
I'd really like to say thank you.
Welcome to this week's Hotline. Well, tonight we look at your comments on programs that we've been showing on SBS in the last week or so, with some very differing opinions, as you'll see. But of course, the big show of the moment is the Tour de France, and whether you're a cyclist or not, what could be better than looking at the French countryside in the summer without leaving your favourite chair?
As a cyclist, I appreciate the Tour de France coverage so much. When it's winter in Melbourne, watching the Tour is so inspiring. Your coverage is televised at a fantastic time and the commentary is spot on.
Congratulations on a brilliant job. Without SBS, we would be nowhere in the coverage of professional cycling, and I thank you.
I've been waiting for this live stage of Tour de France for weeks now, and what happens? When the cyclists are battling it out in the climb to Col du Galibier, all you show is studio chatting. Far out.
When we got to the actual live coverage, it was outstanding and the best I've ever seen. But please cut back on that frustrating lead-up of commentators' comments.
When the Tour de France is screened each evening, could we see or at least hear where it's going to be next day, or even see a little map so we can be all ready with our Atlas and Michelin?
The cycling thing, the Tour de France, for one day and 2 days it's okay, but you know, for so many days to have the same thing going on and on, we don't like it. The normal programming is all right, the Global Village.
Well, the Global Village will be back at 6 o'clock each weeknight when the Tour de France finishes next Tuesday. But until then, well, we think Le Tour is worth keeping track of every day that it's on, as well as our live coverage of the final stage on Sunday, the 27th of July at 9:30 p.m. Now, our daily reports feature maps of where the cyclists are at each stage of the race, but you can also log on to our website where you can see maps of all stages of the event.
I enjoyed this movie very much and had great empathy for the characters, which is quite unusual for me. I do not know much about Finland, but thought the Finnishness was also quite charming. You could see how Finland is slightly different from Norway or Sweden.
I wish to view a certain film and ask your company to broadcast it. The film is titled Happy Together. If you're not intending to screen it, may I, as a customer and avid viewer, ask you to preview this film in the near future?
Well, sorry to say that we've shown Happy Together 3 times already on SBS, but if you're a fan of the films of director Wong Kar-wai, you'll be glad to know his follow-up movie, In the Mood for Love, will go to air sometime next April or May. Worth waiting for. For some viewers who missed this next documentary on its first showing in April, tuned in and called in when we repeated it last Monday.
I'm a big fan of the Lee genre of films, and it was really impressive, and it was good to see the episodes of the movie that weren't originally included.
The documentary itself was a bit bland in the US style, and Lee's final film, The Game of Death, was typically overrated. However, this program had the good sense to give Lee time and space to air his philosophies, which were quite profound.
Just inquiring about the Bruce Lee special and several other things. With the size of the screen on them, I guess it's because of all this digital rubbish, but look, that's like looking through a keyhole. I mean, I don't find that entertaining at all.
Well, it's not so much digital rubbish, but rather the letterbox format that this documentary was shown in. And like most films and many documentaries that we show in letterbox, it allows you to see the whole widescreen picture instead of cropping it down to fit the box. Well, time's almost up for this week's show, but we'll go out with some differing views on last week's cutting-edge documentary, Modern Meat. Until next week, good night.
Each year, an estimated 1 in 4 Americans suffers an important bout of food poisoning, at least a third attributed to contaminated meat.
I work in a food processing plant which also makes hamburgers, and it would be beneficial to show new staff members portions of this video.
I've just noticed that tonight there's a program saying that hamburgers have become the number one choice of the first world as food. Being 65 years old and having eaten, I think, 3 hamburgers in my life, I wonder, does that mean that I'm of the last world or what?
Sunday night, live from Paris, is the final stage of the 2003 Le Tour de France. Join Les Murray for all the action of the Champs-Élysées as cycling's finest cross the finish line.
Only one of them left, and damn it, here goes McGee.
The final stage of Le Tour de France, live to Eastern States this Sunday night from 9:30. Monday night must be time to order pizza.
That pizza place.
Hi, this is the pizza place.
Yes. For pick up or delivery?
Delivery. Here's the thing. I want to have sex with someone.
You've had too much wine.
Yeah.
He has had no sex for 5 months.
I just want to be pounded like a piece of dough, you know what I mean?
Really?
I just need a big pepperoni, you know?
Damn.
Oh, my God. My boyfriend just walked in.
Oh, my God.
I'm just trying to deliver a
pizza. I need you to come down to the shop for sex.
You're trying to get her to come over there and have sex with you in the van?
She's trying to order a pizza and I don't know what's going on.
All new pizza and crank yankers. Monday nights on SBS.
Now, I could be telling you about digital components over its non-digital composite counterpart. Addictive and bi-directional frames, not to mention geo... The benefits of digital are...
Digital television has DVD quality pictures and sound.
We call it DVD quality pictures and sound.
No matter how you explain it.
Leaving Saddam Hussein in possession of weapons of mass destruction for a few more months or years is not an option. Not in a post-September 11th world.
Saddam Hussein has been overthrown, but the debate about the causes of the war and the credibility of the US and British governments has only just begun.
The plan to invade the Middle East is an old plan.
9/11 meant we could actually get rid of Saddam.
Forgeries, distortions, lies.
Witness the development of their crucial propaganda battle.
This time, the product to be marketed is regime change in Baghdad.
These are good days in the history of freedom.
Operation Saddam, 8:30 Tuesday. Theirs is a dramatic tale of exile and starvation, triumph and loss. And now this people's story, the Kingdom of David, is available on video. And the Psalms of David, musical settings to the life of David from Gregorian chant to the present day, on a double CD. The video and CD are available from Dimmicks, video stores, music retailers, online, or by phone order.
And drops the price on a Sony digital camcorder by $150. This Sony Handycam is in our current catalogue for $949. It's now reduced to just $799. That's right, $799 for this Sony Handycam with USB streaming. You save $150. In case you missed it, Harvey Norman have dropped the price on this digital Handycam to $799. Ignore our catalogue price, it's dropped. Pay just $799 now and save $150.
After driving the Hyundai V6 Sonata, motoring website carpoint.com.au said, performance and polish. There's a lot to be said for a test drive.
Ahead in SBS World News tonight, the Australian-led intervention force promises to crack down quickly on lawlessness in the Solomons. The deaths of Saddam's sons failed to stem ongoing violence in Iraq. A reprieve for David Hicks, who won't face the death penalty. And a plum political job up for grabs after California's economic bubble bursts. Details at 9:30.
Hello, I'm Mark Davis. The world is changing rapidly, and so is the way that we report it. Working alone, Dateline's video journalists gain unique access to stories from around the world. Dateline, pushing the boundaries of global current affairs.
Dateline, 8:30, Wednesday.
Jenny Brocky, welcome to Insight. Tonight, the great Telstra debate. Should Telstra finally be sold off?
Well, you can stand here and you can't get any phone coverage with CDMA. Walk to the other side of that BP sign and you can again talk to the world.
I don't think we'll have any voice once Telstra is privatised.
Once you leave Broken Hill, you get a good coverage, but I mean, we're only a very small town out here. We're in the middle of nowhere, so to have a mobile service in itself, I think it's a wonderful thing.
My major problem with the telecommunications in the Donnybrook Shire, the lack of mobile service, lack of coverage, it has a drastic effect on my business.
Yes, how are you?
When the school does things that have to be done through the internet, we just can't do them.
Progress is being made on all fronts.
The federal government seems determined to push ahead with the final sale of Telstra. With promises of extra money for rural and regional services, the government believes it's time for full privatisation. Others disagree. Later, the Communications Minister, Senator Richard Alston, will join me, as will some critics of the sale. But first, Insight travels across Australia to look at who's satisfied with Telstra and who isn't. Our first report is from Lara Cole in rural Queensland.
Drive west of the small central Queensland town of Blackall and you're on the road to Eastwood Station. Not far from town, the bitumen runs out. Out here, mail is delivered only twice a week. There are no daily newspapers and only two radio stations and two television channels. When it rains, these unsealed roads turn to mud. But it hasn't rained at Eastwood for a very long time. Charlie and Jan Gall are checking the water for the few stock left on their station. Drought is tough, but it's accepted as a bitter part of life in this remote place. What the Gauls find hard to live with is the telecommunications drought they're caught in.
And I've drawn you this little picture to try and show you how it happens. This is Blackall in the middle of town. And in that dark bit is town where they all are on copper wire. And then they drew this circle around here, which is measured 32 kilometres from the post office.
Eastwood is 31 kilometres from the post office. It falls just 1 kilometre short of Telstra's zone for remote customers. That hurts. People outside that circle get subsidised services. The Gauls don't. They're inside what Telstra calls a donut, neither close enough to town to benefit from local services, nor far enough out to receive special assistance.
The whole thing is self-sufficient. There is no electricity going to it. It charges its own batteries.
This solar-powered radio concentrator is how Charlie and Jan receive their telephone services from Telstra. They share the tower with their son Peter and his young family, who also live on the property. If the Gauls' home had crossed Telstra's magical 32-kilometre line, there would be a satellite dish sitting alongside their radio concentrator.
Ellen.
As part of Telstra's assistance for remote customers, the Gauls' neighbours, who live outside the donut, were offered free two-way satellite broadband access.
But that then left us out in the cold, and it's the people that live in that donut shape around the town that I'm concerned about, because we're still on radio concentrator telephones, which are fine for voice. We don't have a problem with them for voice, but they were never ever meant to carry data.
And that includes the internet. The peace at Eastwood is palpable, but the need to communicate with the outside world is pressing.
This is my head office here. I mean, today I'm doing a little bit of bookwork because, the 30th of June's not far gone, and we've got to...
Charlie would rather be working outside, but he has a business to run.
We sell sheep and cattle over the internet. We daily want to keep up with wool prices, cattle prices and sheep prices.
But his internet speed is excruciatingly slow.
I'm afraid between 9 and 19 kilobits per second is really not acceptable to us. I think if you gave the general city person, business person, a speed of between 9 and 19 kilobits a second, you'd hear the outcry all over Australia.
What makes it even more frustrating for the Gauls is that it looks unlikely to ever get any better.
Those of us that are sitting in this little donut, as it's referred to, we see no opportunities for further upgrades at all. And partly because we're such a minority group, for example, in this shire, I estimate there are 20 families that are affected by it.
We're going to be close to being on time.
Jan is heading to Pentwyn, a neighbouring property an hour's drive away.
Hello, kids. How are you?
Good, thanks.
That's good.
Michelle Rooney and her family also live inside Telstra's donut.
Yes, Mr. Merritt.
From their home, Michelle teaches her four children through Longreach School of Distance Education, the old school of the air. Technological advances have enormously improved the way isolated children are taught. In some places in Australia, distance education schools have become virtual classrooms. But there's no chance of that happening at Pentwyn.
When a school does things that have to be done through the internet, we just can't do them.
Well, I'm looking for a website called Harry Potter Warmbrus. It won't come up.
Bob is a huge Harry Potter fan. As part of his schoolwork, he's been asked to search websites to recommend them to classmates. We time his attempt. After waiting for 15 minutes, the page crashes. Without even a wave of a wand, Harry Potter has disappeared. But that's nothing unusual at Pentwyn.
You get very annoyed, but you just expect it now. Even just, like, we looked at a clearing sale the other night and they had pictures. We weren't too sure what the pictures were because no subtitles came up underneath. And so we just left it on while the pictures were coming up. Well, the first three pictures were with machinery, which wasn't really what we were looking for. And the first three pictures took over an hour and a half. So, after that, we just gave up. We didn't need to see the rest.
Yes, Tim, what's your question?
Well, we really...
A year one class is in progress at Charleville School of Distance Education. In the past 10 years, technology has opened doors to allow these long-distance teachers instant communications with their students.
Okay, so it's like in Panda, so it starts with the letter P, and that's right at the very top.
But technology has not been shared equally. The term digital divide has been coined to describe the Telstra haves and have-nots in the bush. It leaves these teachers in a digital dilemma. Should they use the technology available and leave behind the few left in Telstra's dead zone, or should they hold back the whole school?
If, for example, if you are emailing students a PowerPoint presentation, we have to think about other ways of getting that presentation to students who have landline connections and slower speeds.
Back on Eastwood, Riley Gore looks out over the property his family has owned for nearly 100 years. In a few years' time, he'll start school.
We are most concerned about it. We've become quite agitated about it, really, because having seen the advances in the last 10 years, it's almost impossible to imagine what might happen in the next 10 years.
After spending most of their lives on the station, Jan and Charlie will soon retire. Their son Peter will take over. Before they move away, Jan and Charlie would like to leave a parting gift. If they could get their wish, it would be improved telecommunications for their children and grandchildren.
We don't expect to have a state-of-the-art hospital right beside us. We don't expect to have a university right here. But because we don't have the benefits of those sort of things, I believe that